For November to January, the Bureau's long-range forecast shows it's likely to be drier than average for southern, western and northern Australia, warmer than average for almost all of Australia, and an El Niño is active and a positive Indian Ocean dipole continues to strengthen. September rainfall was below to very much below average for much of the southern two-thirds of Australia, with some areas in Victoria and New South Wales recording their driest September on record. September maximum temperatures were above average for most of Australia, reaching highest on record for parts of western and southern Australia. Over 300 weather stations recorded a new highest daily maximum temperature for the month of September. September soil moisture was average to above average for most northern and central regions. Soil moisture was below to very much below average across large areas of western, southern and eastern Australia. November to January is likely to be drier than average across areas of southern, western and northern Australia. October to December stream flow forecast is low for most sites and high for some sites in the northeast of western Australia. November to January daytime temperatures are very likely to be above average for almost all of Australia. Warmer than average nights are also very likely for most areas from November to January. An El Niño and a positive Indian Ocean dipole are underway, and central and eastern Pacific sea surface temperatures continue to exceed El Niño thresholds. Models indicate further warming of the central to eastern Pacific Ocean is likely. Climate models indicate this positive Indian Ocean dipole is likely to persist until at least the end of December, and the El Niño is likely to persist until at least the end of February. When positive Indian Ocean dipole and El Niño events occur together, the drying effect is typically strengthened across Australia. For more information, visit bomb.gov.au/climate.